A very good morning all. Today we will discuss about an metabolism of glycine. It is a non-essential amino acid and it is an optically inactive amino acid. In metabolic classification, it belongs to the glucogenic amino acid, so it will give glucose. Then it is incorporated into the protein during protein synthesis, especially in the collagen. Collagen contain near about 30% of glycine. Then there are different specialized products which are given by the glycine. First one is the heme. It is responsible for heme synthesis. Then it gives creatine, which is converted into creatinine and creatine phosphate. Then it is responsible for formation of glutathione. It helps in the conjugation reactions. So these are the important functions of glycine, that is heme synthesis, creatine formation, glutathione formation, conjugation reactions. And it is also utilized for synthesis of purines, that is C3, C4 and N7 of purine ring. It is given by the glycine. Now coming to the glycine formation, the serine and threonine. These amino acids gives glycine. Threonine by the threonine aldolase will give glycine. And serine by the serine hydroxymethyl transferase. By the hydroxymethyl transferase, it will give glycine. Then there is synthesis of glycine from the ammonia, CO2 and N5, N10, methylene, tetrahydrofolate. These three compounds will give you glycine with the help of enzyme glycine synthase. Glycine synthase. This is a reversible reaction. And it is a major fate in metabolic fate of glycine, that is conversion into ammonia, CO2 and this one carbon unit, that is N5, N10, methylene, THO. So this is a reversible reaction. Again in metabolism, this glycine is converted into serine. This glycine is converted into serine and serine then is converted into pyruvate, which gives glucose, and serine again it is converted into, through the various steps, it is converted into glyoxylate. So this glyoxylate is converted into oxalate and formate. Formate get excreted in urine. So, in the degradation of glycine, it will give you this glycine is converted into glyoxylate by the glycine oxidase, and this glyoxylate will it is converted into oxalate, which is excreted in urine, and it will give one carbon unit, that is formate. Formate. So this is the degradation. In the reversible reaction, this glyoxylate by the transaminase, it is converted into glycine. So this is a metabolism of glycine. It is a glucogenic amino acid. It will give glucose. Then it is incorporated into the protein. Then it gives specialized product, that is heme, creatinine, glutathione. Then it is synthesis of glycine occurs from the three compound. First one is the serine, second one is the threonine, and third one is the by the glycine synthase activity. Then in degradation, the major metabolic fate is ammonia, CO2 and one carbon unit by the glycine synthase, NADH dependent glycine synthase in the degradation. Then glycine in degradation, it is converted into glyoxylate by the glycine oxidase. Glyoxylate is converted into oxalate and oxalate get excreted in the urine. It also gives the one carbon unit, which is utilized in the one carbon metabolism. This in reversal, this glyoxylate is by the transamination, glycine transaminase, it is converted into glycine. And defect in this glycine transaminase lead to the disorder known as primary hyperoxaluria. Primary hyperoxaluria. So it is a, now it is believed that it is a protein targeting defect. Protein targeting defect. So it in targeting defect, because of defective targeting, it goes into the mitochondria in place of peroxisome. So this is a protein targeting defect of primary of glycine transaminase. And another disorder which is related to this pathway is the glycinuria, which is due to the defective renal absorption, reabsorption of glycine. So these are the two disorders, glycinuria and primary hyperoxaluria. So oxalate stones are excreted and deposited in urine in the patient with primary hyperoxaluria. Coming to the specialized product given by the glycine, in the specialized product given by the glycine, the important one is the glutathione. So it helps in the formation of glutathione. Since glutathione is the main molecule which is required for the maintaining the RBC integrity. So in glutathione formation, it is a glutamyl cysteinyl glycine. So it is a glutamyl cysteinyl glycine. So glycine helps in the formation of glutathione. Then glycine plus succinyl coenzyme A, it through the various steps it will give heme. So it is important in the heme synthesis. Then glycine plus arginine gives the gonadoacetate. It is in the kidney, and this gonadoacetate by accepting methyl group from S-adenosylmethionine, it is converted into creatine. This creatine is converted into creatine phosphate, and by removal of phosphate it is converted into creatinine, or by this, by removal of water molecule, it is converted into creatinine. So these are the three important metabolites, or these are the three important products which are given by the glycine. It also helps in the conjugation reaction. In conjugation reaction, it combines with the benzoyl CoA, coenzyme A plus glycine, and there is excretion of hippuric acid in urine. Hippuric acid in urine. Also, in the conjugation reaction, it helps in the formation of glycocholic acid, glycocholate, that is the bile salt, and glycosinodeoxycholate. So, summarizing the glycine, glycine synthesizes from the serine, threonine, and by the action of glycine synthase. These are the three ways by which glycine synthesizes. In degradation, glycine mainly degraded into ammonia, CO2 and one carbon unit. Then it is degraded into glyoxylate, which is converted into formate and oxalate, and oxalate excreted in the urine. In the degradation, it is converted into serine. Serine is converted into pyruvate, which is utilized for the glucose synthesis. Then two important disorders, that is glycine urea. It is due to the defective renal reabsorption of glycine. And second is the primary hyperoxalouria. It is due to the defective protein targeting, that is glycine transaminase in mitochondria in place of the peroxisomes. So these are the two disorders. In special metabolites given by the glycine, the glutathione, heme, creatine, and it helps in the conjugation reaction. And in collagen, near about 30% of glycine is formed. So this is all about the glycine. You may get a short note in the university exam on the glycine. So keep watching. Thank you.